Hey there, and welcome to today's Orthos Liquid Systems video chat. I'm Stuart Humphreys, Director of Filtration Technologies for Orthos.
Today I want to discuss triangular underdrains. Using the military phonetic alphabet, let's call them Tango Uniform. This type of underdrain is made with thin stainless steel sheet metal with laterals connected directly to a center flume or to an end flume box with gaskets. Tango Uniform laterals are short with a small cross-sectional area as compared to plastic block or certainly the open plenum of Orthos Centurion monolithic. In other videos, I've addressed the maldistribution problems due to Tango Uniform's greatly increased velocities for the same required flow rates as other underdrains. What I haven't discussed before is its performance over the range of flow rates that operators utilize. Let's focus on water backwash, though problems with varying air scour rates are similar. Tango Uniform has an upper and lower conduit for air and water respectively. During combined air-water backwash, water flow rates are commonly 4 to 8 GPM per square foot. Afterward, during the fluidizing rinse, flow rates are 3 to 5 times as high, perhaps 15 to 22 GPM per square foot, depending on the media, water temperature, and other factors. Now let's think of a really long tube with holes in it. Do you really think that the same flow comes out of each hole all the way down the long tube at 4 GPM per square foot, then also at 22 GPM per square foot? It's impossible. And why specifications for Tango Uniform only list one backwash flow rate? Because that's the rate that's used to size the slots. Mr. Operator, want to use 15 GPM per square foot because the water is really cold? Get ready for maldistribution. And at 4 GPM per square foot during combined air water wash? Better have the air on so you won't be disappointed to see what's happening with the water. Conversely, the three-dimensional plenum of an Orthos Centurion buffers the pressures with its nozzles equalizing the distribution, no matter the flow rate. In another video, I also address proper commissioning testing of filters. I have yet to see Tango Uniform manufacturers agree to perform any of these stringent multiple flow rate tests. Instead, they go to great lengths in attempt to explain why AWWA's methods of peer-reviewed filter testing are incorrect and demand test boxes instead. These vertical towers are connected to a lateral and the rise of the water level measured during backwash. The problem is, if the test boxes are installed near each other on the same lateral, they are hydraulically connected, and with the same slot openings, of course they'll have the same water level. It's magic. They're perfectly equal with zero maldistribution. Instead, a more proper test would be at the same time, every second, measure the level in 7 boxes on 7 different laterals in 7 different places along the lateral lengths at different flow rates. Then again, I'll likely be Tango Uniform myself before that's agreed to.
Please contact me or your local Orthos representative for any of your filtration, contactor, or ion exchange needs. And subscribe to the Orthos YouTube channel. Follow us on Twitter or LinkedIn me. I'm Stuart Humphreys. Talk with you again soon.